Assalamu alaikum guys, hope everyone is doing great. Welcome to the sixth video of series of the lectures or videos in which we are doing the FPSC preparation, Federal Public Service Commission of Pakistan. And this is the sixth video for the topic of building materials. In last video we have done the multiple choice questions related to timber and wood. And in today's video, we will first discuss the theory and important points related to paint, because the next coming MCQs are going to be related to the paint. So in today's video, we will discuss about paint first, and in the next coming video we will solve the multiple choice questions or objective questions related to paint. So let's start with paint. We will first discuss the type of paints, and then we will study about the constituents of paint and their functions. So let's first study about the type of paints. What are the type of paints and what are their functions? So before starting the different types of paints, we will first see what are the reasons why we actually do the painting. Painting is normally carried out for following reasons. The first is protecting surface from insects, rain, solar radiations and other external factors. And the second point is similar maintenance. Well painted surfaces are easier to keep clean and safe. This is second reason. The third is to increase the visual appeal of a surface, obviously. The fourth reason why we do painting is waterproofing. And the fifth reason for doing the painting is to increase the surface durability. These are some reasons why we do paint. The next thing is that before selecting the type of paint for a specific application, its physical properties must be considered, right? So before doing the paint for a specific application, like either we are doing the paint on wood, either we are doing the paint on a steel member or something else. So first we have to see and consider the physical properties, and then we will select a type of paint, and then we will apply that paint on that specific item like wood, steel or concrete. So a good paint should have the following properties, and a good paint gives the following benefits. A good paint is easy to apply, reasonable drying period, right? Forming a thin film without cracking, forming a hard and durable coating, its performance should not be affected by the weather, not harmful for the users. If any paint contains all these properties, that paint is called a good paint. We will call that paint a good paint. So let's start with different types of paints. The first paint is oil paint. Actually, in paint there are different constituents, like there will be a base. Paint is actually a combination of a base, vehicle, color pigments, thinner, drier, and then adulterants. These are the constituents of a paint. So when you look into the oil paint, what is oil paint? Oil paint uses white lead as a base. Actually, there are different bases. For example, if you look at the base, white lead, lead sulfate, sublime lead, red lead, zinc oxide, all these are bases, but their use is different. Like if you are using oil paint, you will use white lead as a base. If you are doing some sort of a different paint on steel structures, then you will use red lead as a base. So there are different bases, and each of the base has different function, and each of the base is used in different kind of paints. So white lead is used in oil paints. Oil paint uses white lead as a base and are applied in three coats. We apply three coats of oil paint. If you are doing oil paint, you should apply three coats: primer, undercoat, and finish coat. Right? Oil paints can achieve matte and glossy finishes while being durable and affordable too. These are the properties of oil paint. They are characterized by their ease of application and painted surface and easy to clean. Oil paint is commonly used in these uses are important. Oil paints are used for walls, doors, windows, and metal structures. And with this, they have also mentioned one of the, you can say, disadvantage of oil paint. Oil paint is not suitable for humid conditions, and it takes time to dry completely. So also, before applying oil paint, linseed oils and pigments must be added, because linseed is a constituent of oil. We will, let's see here, what is linseed? Let me find it out. It's a dryer, I guess. Linseed is a dryer. Where is it? Linseed. If there are humid conditions, we need to use linseed oil as a vehicle in the paint, like oil paint. So these were some uses, definition of oil paint, what is oil paint, and then some properties, and then its uses, and then some gaps, or you can say disadvantage of oil paint. And then second is enamel paint. Enamel paint, this type of paint is produced by adding lead or zinc to the varnisher. We add lead or zinc to the varnisher. Pigments are added to achieve a wide variety of colors. Color pigments, we will study about these constituents or components of paint in the coming few minutes. So then pigments are added to get the desired color. Enamel paints form hard and glossy coating, which are easily cleaned, same as oil paint. Oil paint is also easy to clean. And important point is that they are being considered as waterproof and chemically resistant, offering good coverage and color retention. This is a plus point of enamel paint. So the uses of enamel paints are interior and exterior walls. We can use it in both interior and exterior walls because they are good with the humid conditions. Wood timbers, doors and flooring, windows, stairs, surfaces like wickers, masonry, concrete, plaster, glass, and metals. So enamel paint has a lot more uses as compared to the oil paint. Oil paint is just commonly used in walls, doors, windows, and metal structures. And what is the limitation? Actually, we need to notice the uses and limitation of each type of paint. So the limitation of enamel paint is that they dry very slowly. You know, they get dry very slowly. What will happen if it gets dry slowly? If it gets dry slowly, it can get dirt or dust quickly, right? The next paint type of paint is emulsion paint. Emulsion paints are polyvinyl acetate and polystyrene as binding materials. The binding materials used for emulsion are these two. Right? Binding materials, we also call them vehicles. Binding materials are known as vehicles. Let's see the definition of vehicle. It helps the paint to separate the base over the surface, and it acts as a binder between base and pigment. So those binders are also called vehicles. This is also an important point to note. So they contain dryers. Like dryers used in emulsion paints are cobalt and manganese. They can be water or oil based, and pigments are used to achieve the desired color. Emulsion paints are characterized by their fast drying. These are fast drying, right? Enamel paints are slow dryers. Emulsion paints are fast dryers, and hardening and surface can be cleaned easily. I think most of the paints have that property that they can be cleaned easily with water. And one more important point, important property of emulsion paint is that they are resistant to the alkalis. And what are the common uses? The common uses are interior walls, ceiling, and masonry work. They are not, we can't use emulsion paints for the exterior walls because they are not good when it comes to the connection of the paint or application with the water or moisture, right? So we use it for interior wall, ceilings, masonry work. And there are some specific type of emulsion paints which can be used for woodwork. Otherwise, it is mostly used for wall, ceilings, and masonry work. Cement paint. The name shows that the paint which we are going to apply on the cement works or cement components are called cement paint. Cement paint is available in powder form, which is mixed with water to achieve paint consistency. Right? Cement paint, you can get a question like, which paint is available in powder form? Cement paint, enamel paint, bitumen paint, or oil paint? Then the right option for that question, the right answer for that question will be cement paint. It is available in powder form. And then this powder is mixed with water to achieve the paint consistency. The base material is white or colored cement. The base we are using in this paint is white or colored cement, and it may also contain pigments, accelerators, and other additives. Again, these are properties. Cement paint is durable, waterproof, and it is commonly used in rough internal and external surfaces. Those surfaces which are rough, we use cement paints on the surfaces which are rough, and it has the disadvantage that it has long drying time, typically 24 hours. Okay, and next is bituminous paint. The type of paint is made from dissolved asphalt or tar, which gives it a characteristic black color. It is waterproofed and alkali resistant. Bitumen paint, actually, wherever we need waterproofing, we used to do the bitumen painting, right? We have, like, in the foundations, in the basements, in the water tanks, we used to do the bitumen painting. It is used in underwater iron works, concrete foundations, wooden surfaces, and iron pipelines. So these are the uses of bitumen paint. It helps provide rust resistance. These are rust resistant paint, and they are most of the time used in metals or the foundation or concrete work which is connected to the water. Aluminium paint. The type of paint is produced by mixing aluminium particles with oil varnish. It is resistant to corrosion. It is also resistant to corrosion, electricity, and weather exposure. The items which are exposed to the weather or which have some sort of connection with the electricity, for those items we use aluminium paint. It is commonly used for metals and woods, and some specific applications are gas tanks, oil tanks, water pipelines, and radiators. And some other types of paints, I guess these are not that much important because I have noticed there are not many questions related to these paints, but we will just go through the names of the remaining types of paints. This is anti-corrosive paint, and synthetic rubber paint. cellulose paint, and then plastic paint, silicate paint, and the last one is cesium paint. So at least above, there are many types of paints and their application vary greatly. The reason to use paint in construction include visual appeal, surface durability, chemical protection, and pest protection. Each type of paint is designed for specific applications. Obviously, adequate paint selections can reduce project cost while improve the performance. Paint is often regarded as an aesthetic improvement for building, but it brings many technical advantages as well. These include chemical protection and easier maintenance. So these were different types of paint, and then let's finish it by discussing the constituent we are going to use in the paint and their functions. In paint, a paint is a combination of a base, vehicle, color pigments, thinner, drier, and adulterants, right? These are the components or constituents of a paint. What is base? Base is actually metallic oxides. They act as the body of paint, and it helps the paint to become hard and resistant to the weathering. This is the function of a base. And there are various examples of base. As I already told you, that each of the example has different function, different usage in different paint. Like we use white lead in oil paint, red sulfate will be used in different sort of paint, and each of this example has use in different paint. Like if you are doing a paint on steel work, we will use red lead as a base. Vehicle, it helps the paint to separate the base over the surface. The main function of vehicle is that it helps the base which we have added into the paint, it helps the base to easily separate over the surface wherever we are doing the painting. And it also acts as a binder between base and pigment. Vehicle acts as a binder between base and color pigment. Some examples of vehicles are, actually, vehicles are linseed oils. Linseed oils of raw, refined, wobble boiled, and pale linseed oil. These are four examples of vehicles. Again, these have different applications in different paints. Color pigment, the material added to paint to get final desired color is called color pigment. The name is also showing that the function of color pigment is a material which helps the paint to get the final desired color. Examples of color pigments are lamp black, bone black, graphite, Indian red, chromium yellow, and there are various other color pigments. And the thinner is a material used to reduce consistency of the paint. It enables the paint to separate easily over the surface with brush and to penetrate into the surface. As name is also showing, that thinner means it makes the paint thin, right? And when paint becomes thin, it helps to separate that paint easily over the surface. And when we brush that paint after adding the thinner, it will easily penetrate into the small pores of the surface. Turpentine oil is the most commonly used thinner. The next is drier. Again, this name is shows and it defines the function of this material. Drier is used, it helps to dry the paint, and the material used to accelerate the action of drying. It accelerates the drying process of a paint because paint needs to be dried soon to avoid the risk of catch of dust and dirt. It is important to dry out the paint as soon as possible because if it gets late, it can catch dust and dirt. The example of dryer is litharge. This should not be used in finishing coat. Important thing is that dryer should not be used in the finishing coat, last coat, because it can affect the final desired color. So we will just use the dryer in first or second coat, nor in the final coat. If you use it in the final coat, it can affect the final desired color. And the last is adulterants. Adulterants, these are the materials used to reduce the cost of paint and also reduce the weight to increase its durability. Example is barium sulfate. Its property is that it is cheap and it does not react with paint. This is the property of adulterant. This is most commonly used adulterant, but the other adulterants available are calcium carbonate, magnesium silicate and silica. So these were some important points related to paint. Let's close this video, finish this lecture here, and in the next video we will solve and discuss the multiple choice questions and objectives related to paint for building materials. So till then, goodbye. Take good care.